How's it going, everybody? Welcome to We Do Tech. Now, probably the most asked questions that I get does revolve around my desk setup. A lot of you guys do like my setup, and you guys usually want to know, how did I get it look like this? What products do I use? And just some of the tips that I can give you. So in this video, I thought I'd give you guys some tips, tricks, and also the products that I use and I would recommend you get if you want to make your desk setup look better. But just before that, if you guys are in the market for a new keyboard, RebelTech has you covered with the high quality keyboards from Ducky. I recently did my review of the Ducky 1-2 Midnight Edition. So definitely check out the links in the video description if you want to purchase one for yourself or check out my review. So starting off with our first point, and that is cable management. This is probably the most important part to make your setup look better. If you have a great setup with crazy hardware and everything, but your cable management looks awful, your entire setup is gonna look awful. If you don't really have that great of a setup, but your cable management is at least good, it's going to help out a lot. So some of the products that I recommend you get is definitely an IKEA Raceway. This thing is a lifesaver. All you need to do is screw it onto your desk or double side tape it. Screw it on will work better. Just put on all of your cables into that. It does have a nice hook, so you can route all of your cables through that or just bundle it up there. We'd say that you maybe need it up a bit. It's just gonna look better, but either way, it works. Just as long as there's no cables on the ground or hanging, that is going to work perfectly. Along with that, I would do recommend that you do get some cable clips. So these ones, you do get a few. I personally have two different ones. So first up is the smaller ones. That is just enough to handle like one or two cables. Just double-sided tape it to your desk, and then it just clips into the cables and it's nice and neat. It's very cheap and you can get like a pack of like 50 or 100 and it's not too expensive. So otherwise you can get the bigger ones, which is able to handle bigger cables and then more of them. So you can either go for one of those. It works perfectly. It keeps it nice and neat. You don't have to use any hot glue to glue anything to your desk. If you don't like it, you can tear it off and you can use it, you can use a different one later on without damaging your desk as well. Now with my desk in particular, you will see that I don't really have a multi-plug around here. I do have that one, and the other one is below this and then up there. So usually you can either use double-sided tape to stick it onto your desk or underneath your desk. I did use that. The double-sided tape wasn't strong enough with all of the cables that I used, so it did start to fall off. So I put it there. It's nice and neat. You don't have to worry. But if you don't have that many cables, just stick it up here, or you can get something like this. It's just like a footstool where you can rest your feet on. It's nothing too fancy. It doesn't look the greatest. I want to get something else for that, but it does keep the cables and the multi-plug out of sight. So that is something. Otherwise, you can go for a multi-plug box or a cable box, whatever they call it. Just put in your multi-plug into that. It does have some open grooves where you can just route your cables through to whatever device needs powering, and it just keeps it nice and clean. You do also get it in black or white. I don't believe in other colors, but it's a good option if you just want to hide it and just put it somewhere safe. And then finally, after you've done all of your cable management, to make it just look that much better, you can use cable sleeves. These ones, you can get a few different ones. I personally have the cloth zipper ones. All you need to do is bundle up your cables together, wrap around the sleeve, zip it up, and that's it. So it looks a lot better if it's just one single like black cable instead of just these multiple ones that sometimes can get a bit loose and just pair up from the other ones, and that kind of will ruin your desk setup again. So cable sleeve works great either behind your monitors or just behind your desk kind of down. Is going to work excellent. And then as for our next point, and that is lighting. Now you don't have to go for anything lighting. It's just going to add a bit of more ambient color to your setup and just make it look more vibrant. So you don't really have to go for anything crazy like I have here. I've gone full RGB. I personally like that. not everybody do. So I would otherwise recommend, if you don't want to go for crazy RGB like this, just go for a single LED strip like behind your desk with just like white or more of an orange color or blue, whatever. Or you can go for something like a unique set of a lamp and then pair it up with some of those Edison bulbs. They do look really unique, and it's just going to add something different to your desk, make it look just more unique again. Now, as for my crazy RGB setup, there's a ton of things that you can add. Don't have to go as crazy as I have, but just going over some of the stuff, I use the Corsair LL fans inside my PC. You don't have to go for that. It does kind of cost a bit much. You can go for something a bit cheaper, but otherwise you can just add some of the LED strips. So I personally down here have one of those cheap Amazon ones. Nothing too crazy. It just works with one of those remotes, and it's nice and bright. I personally use it just on a single color, like this blue, for example. Just adds a bit of ambient lighting underneath my desk, and I personally like that. Next up, we have the LED strip behind my desk. Now, this one is something a bit different as well. This is actually some of the lighting strips from Corsair. So they're not as bright as some of these other light strips that I will also go over again. They're not as bright, but they are a digital RGB LEDs. So you have more control over them. You can get that rainbow effect with them, where with these ones and some of the other ones behind my monitor, you can't. So that is a great option to make it look more cool. It does cost more, but you can control everything through the IQ software from Corsair. All of your RGB fans, your LED strips, if you have some of the Corsair RGB peripherals, you can go for that as well. Otherwise, I did also see that NZXT has some new ambient lighting LEDs going around now. I'm not sure if it's officially out yet, but you can look at them. It's going to work with what's displayed on your monitor, so that's going to look really cool. It's also quite expensive things, $100 or so on. But next up, we have my Xiaomi Yi lights. Now, these ones I do really like. It's probably one of my favorite tech devices. You can go for some of the Philips ones. These ones are kind of just the cheaper equivalents. But now you do get two different ones. First up, I have my RGBW bulbs. Now, these ones are just normal LED bulbs that you can screw into whatever light, and then you can control it through your phone. So you download the app, it's RGB. It can also go just white to add a bit more lighting, and it's just going to add a bit more color to your setup. But again, you can just choose white or orange or whatever if you wanted to. Next up, we do also have the Xiaomi Yi light strip behind my monitor that I recently added again. Again, that one is a bit more brighter than the Corsair digital LEDs, and it's kind of the same as this one down here. You can also control that one through your phone. It's going to look awesome. You can choose whatever color you would want, and it's just going to add a ton of more ambient lighting for your entire setup to make it like stand out a bit more. And then as for our next point, it's really simple, but that is to get a monitor stand or a monitor arm. Now, I do get a few different arms. You can either get ones that connect to your desk or to the wall, like the one I have for the TV. But for the monitors, you can either get one like with three arms, if you have a triple monitor setup, or you can just get a single one, which just is the single leg that connects to your monitor. This is going to help with cable management a lot more. You'll be able to adjust your monitor's height and tilt and all of that to make it just work perfect for you. Again, you want to keep it kind of eye level, because otherwise, if you're looking down, it can damage your neck. So you want to keep it eye level, and it's going to work very well for that. I kind of went with a custom DIY monitor stand that I just made out of melamine wood. It's really simple, just cut a few of these legs, and it does look nice and neat. You can go for paid ones as well. You do get them on Amazon. We'll leave a few in the description. But for mine, because it's three of them, I kind of had to go for a custom one. The reason I went with this instead of a triple monitor arm is because one of my monitors don't have a VESA mount, so I can't really connect all of them to that, and it's going to look weird if I only have like two of those. So that's why I went with this custom DIY monitor stand. But later on, if I get different monitors, I will most likely mount them to the wall. It's just going to look that much cleaner. And then as for our next point, that's pretty much self-explanatory, as you guys can see. It is to have some sort of headphone stand. Now, there's nothing less attractive than just having your headphones all on your desk, cables everywhere. It's going to look horrible. So to have some sort of headphone stand, it's just going to look that much better. I personally have three of them here, three different ones. And then also I do have one down here where you can neatly hang your headphone there. It's going to look nice and neat, out of the way, and it's not going to clutter up your desk. But now, as for these ones, I do just have a simple one here. Not the greatest, but it's from Sharkoon, and it works. I do personally have the Corsair ST1000 as well. Does have a USB hub. You have your audio connection right here. It's RGB and it looks really cool. I do really like it. I personally use it every day. And then finally, you get the very cheap one and very popular one on Amazon. And that's just this simple headphone stand. You just connect your, put your headphones on it, and it's just nice and neat. You can wrap around your cable around the base here, and it's just going to keep it out of the way. So pretty simple, but it's definitely something that you are going to need to keep your setup nice and neat. And then next up is to have a cool wallpaper. The wallpaper is some of the things that somebody's going to see first of your gaming setup, and you're pretty much almost always going to look at it. So to have a cool wallpaper is very important. There's a ton of just Google images that you can just go search, download, and use, and it will look nice. But if you really want to make your setup stand out, you can get something like what I have, which is Wallpaper Engine, where you can actually get a movable wallpapers. You can get some really interesting ones. I'm not going to go over everything in this video. I did make a dedicated review on Wallpaper Engine, which I will leave a link in the video description, but you can get a whole bunch of ones that you can interact with, that's always moving. You can use videos, all of that, GIFs, whatever you want. Just to give you guys a quick example, this is kind of the stuff that you can do. It's going to be a bit crazy, but you can use like different wallpapers on each of your monitors. You can split up your monitors into like two parts to get wallpapers on each of those parts, and just make it look really interesting. There's a ton of wallpapers that you can go download. There's always new ones going around, so you can always spice up your setup with a new wallpaper. So definitely check out the review that I did of Wallpaper Engine in the link in the video description. And then finally, just some accessories that you can add to your desk to make it look better and more practical to use. So first up, I have just a phone stand, pretty simple one. I don't have a wireless charging phone, so I don't have a wireless charging headphone stand, but I would do recommend, if you do have one, go for a wireless one. It's going to work a lot better. Charge your phone always, it's going to be very handy. Next up, it's just some cosmetic items that you can add to your desk, some plants, fake plants that you can just add. It does add a ton of just more color to your desk, just to have something like that. I have a lot of Star Wars stuff, like this small Wookiee there, got a bunch of stuff there as well. And then also I recently added just some red cosmetic, like this Lamborghini or this tractor thing. So it's just going to add a bit more color to your desk, and it's just going to make your desk look a bit fuller. If you don't want to go for something like that, to keep it a bit more clean, just a single fake plant is going to look very well if you want to go for something a bit more less busy. So plants are always a good option to go for. Next up is to have a USB hub underneath your desk or just close by. You can just connect your USBs to your PC, but if your PC is far away from you, or if you have to reach far for it, it kind of gets a bit of a hassle. So to have a USB hub underneath your desk is going to help out a lot. Just reach over for that, plug it in. You can sometimes even charge your phone through that, depending on which one you have. I personally use mine all the time. It's a lifesaver, and I would definitely recommend using one. It's just really handy to have it. And then finally is to have a good mouse pad. Now, you can either get one that really works good for gaming, or you can just get something that looks really cool. So I just kind of went with a huge black one and that just kind of has the Li and Li name here at the top. It's out of the way, you don't really see it compared to some of the other ones out there that like looks like crazy. So I kind of like the black, so I can use my keyboard on that and then my mouse. The tracking isn't the best for gaming, but it's still okay. Otherwise, if I play like a lot of games, I use my Razer Goliathus one. Works a lot better, it's a lot more smoother, so I can just kind of switch it out. Sometimes I even just put it over, but to have a dedicated large gaming one is going to work a lot better. I know the Steel Series, quick extra large one, it's really big, but it's going to work excellent for anything you do. Bit pricey, but that's something that I honestly am looking at getting for myself. So that is an option that you can go for as well. But there's a lot cheaper ones out there that you can use. I will leave links in the video description for those as well. So that's pretty much it for this video. I do hope you guys found this informative. If some of you might already have everything that I mentioned before, some of you might not, but it's just always good to go over some of the stuff you might have forgotten, but now you can perhaps add that to your setup to make it look that much better. Now then, as for all of the products that I mentioned in this video, I will leave the links in the video description. I will try to add all of them. There's a bunch of them, so I will leave those in the video description. And then also, if you guys have any other tips or some other products that you would recommend, let me know down in the comments below so we can share it with all of the other people and make all of our gaming setups just look that much better. So that's pretty much it. If you guys have any other idea for a video that you would want me to make, let me know down in the comments below as well. And if you found this a video informative, please like, share, subscribe, and comment like always. And then I will check all of you next time. Cheers, guys.